Here's a gimmicky publishing trend I didn't think was going to last as long as it did. Books that, based on their titles and covers, looked like made-up parody gags, but then when you open it up and read it, holy crap, someone actually wrote the whole dopey book. Huh. The modern iteration of the genre was popularized by author Seth Graham Smith with 2009's Pride and Prejudice and Zombies, but the first one to make it to the big screen has turned out to be another Graham Smith opus, Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter. In a way, that's unsurprising. Unlike Pride, which inserted a period zombie outbreak into an otherwise faithful retelling of Jane Austen's classic mashup style, Lincoln was more or less a straightforward work of historical fantasy with a big flashy hook in the title and premise. It's still a joke, yes, but the joke is less, heh, President Lincoln didn't really fight vampires, and more, huh, President Lincoln didn't really fight vampires, but this thing is written like a straight-faced, no-joke historical chronicle as though he had. It's a funny bit of prolonged deadpan humor, a joke where the joke is that the joke doesn't know that it's a joke, but the lingering question hovering over the new movie adaptation, produced by Tim Burton and directed by Timur Bekmambetov, is whether or not that one joke can sustain an entire feature. Well, kinda, yeah. The basic joke of a recognizable historical figure recast as an axe-wielding period version of Blade is consistently amusing, and oddly enough, people with a better-than-average grasp of the real history in question will probably get more out of it as other real-life figures and events slip into and out of the narrative. But what takes it above and beyond is that it's not always a joke. See, the trick to this whole enterprise is that the main obvious gag is concealing a slightly more subtle surprise. Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter actually does want to be about something. The story's alternate history is prefixed on the idea that Lincoln was a vampire hunter before he was a politician, and ultimately the 16th President of the United States, driven to hunt and kill the undead as vengeance for the murder of his mother. The big central conceit is that the American South is becoming infested with such creatures, because the Southern plantation aristocracy is in reality a vampire conspiracy set up to use the slave trade as a food supply. The knowledge of this drives Lincoln to infiltrate politics and turn his personal crusade into something much bigger. Yep. That's the big gag. The Confederacy was actually an attempt to create a vampire nation, and the Civil War was Lincoln's bid to wipe out the children of the night once and for all. Sure, slavery equals vampirism is a little bit on the nose as metaphors go, but in context, that's actually kind of edgy for an ostensibly satirical goof of a movie, considering how strong a hold Lost Cause revisionism about the Confederacy still holds over American popular culture. I'll be pretty interested to hear and read reviews of the film from critics with Southern and/or Confederate roots, given that it can't really be argued that the film isn't engaged in literal demonization, casting their historical and/or geographic ancestors as an army of monsters, with the Union righteously charged with wiping them out. In any case, I thought the movie was a lot of fun. The historical jokes are a hoot, and the fact that nobody ever seems to acknowledge the whole enterprise as a joke makes it all the funnier. Most of its problems are in the realm of pacing, trying to compress the decade-spanning scope of what is at least in part a historical biography into the beats of a tongue-in-cheek action movie makes some scene-to-scene transitions feel a little more than awkward, particularly when it gets to the Civil War and Lincoln himself isn't on the front lines as much. The action scenes themselves also get a bit repetitive. They're all very well staged, to be sure, but once you've seen one scene of Lincoln excessively cool kung fu axe fighting, you've kinda seen them all. There's one real standout sequence where Honest Abe battles a vampire in the midst of a horse stampede that shows some impressive visual imagination, but it does start to run together after a while. No matter how meta-cool the image of Abraham Lincoln personally kicking down the door of a plantation manor where vampire Confederates are feasting on slaves and axing everybody is conceptually. Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter is, in the end, just a gimmicky joke of a movie, but it tries just hard enough that it actually feels like something more substantial. It isn't, of course, but at least while it's going, you kind of feel like it could be. See you next time!